So welcome back, and we're back out on the job site. And today, what I wanted to show you is how we can develop the 8 bevels for a hip roof out on the job site using what we call proportional triangles. So all you're going to need for this method is a scrap of timber, a bit of ply or something. This one's approximately 400 millimeters long and about 200 millimeters wide. And you're going to need your pencil, your ruler, square, and calculator just to work out the rise of the roof. And then you should be okay. So just before we get started, I just want to have a quick look at the actual roof. So as you can see, here's our hip roof. And the main bit we're going to concentrate on is this section down here, which is just a portion of the roof, which is 1 meter by 1 meter. Okay, and if you know your Pythagoras, if we've got a distance here of 1 meter and a rise of 1 meter, we end up with the hypotenuse being 1 meter 414. So they're the dimensions we're going to use for our proportional triangles. So the meter will be representational of our half span, and the 1414 will be representational of the plan length of our hip. So we'll come back over to a bit of timber, and the first thing I need to do is find the center of the timber, and I'm just going to put a line up there most of the way up the board. So that's where we're going to start from. So I don't need these anymore. So I'm going to start on the right hand side, and I'm going to come out 100 mil, but obviously 100 mil, sorry, 1 meter. Obviously, 1 meter's not going to fit on the board, so we can just divide it by 10. So 1 meter or 1,000 millimeters divided by 10 obviously is going to equal 100. So I'm going to come out 100 mil, 100 mil on this side. Now we need to work out our rise for the roof. So on this roof, I'm going to go 30 degrees, so 30 times a 10 gives me 577 millimeters. So I'll put that in millimeters. So back 577 and divide that by 10. So 57.7 millimeters. So I can come up off here 57. Point try 0.7, and that's my rise on my roof. So I can now draw in that line there and get rid of that to save confusion. Get rid of those two. Okay, so what I've got my representation of a half span, which is 100 mil. I've got my proportion of my rise, which has turned out to be 57.7, and that'll give me this line here, which is the true length or representational of the true length of the common rafter. So having that information, I've now got a bevel here, and I've got a bevel here. And we'll label those up. So this one's gonna be number one, and this one's number two. So 1 is equal to the plumb bevel of the common rafter, and two is the level for the common rafter. Tidy that up. Okay, so that's pretty simple so far. So the next step, we'll want to work out the edge bevel for our common rafter. So what we need to do, we need to take this 100 mil here, and we're going to develop it up so it comes off here at 90 degrees to our true length. So 90 degrees, 100 mil long, and then we can join that back to there. So that's 100 mil long. And that'll give us a bevel here that is our edge bevel for our creeper. Right. And for those that have done a few of these videos before, we know that opposite our edge bevel creeper, we have the edge bevel for the purlin. So 4 is the edge level purlin. Okay, so that's that side of the timber done. Now we want to have a look at the other side. So the other side, we're going to look at the hip. And if we remember back to our plan of our roof, we're going to use this 1 meter 414. That's our base measurement. So go back to the calculator. 1414 divided by 10 is going to give us 141.4. So I need to come off here. 141.4 gives us a point there, which I can then take up. The rise is going to be the same. And I'll tidy up, get rid of this. Did that right at the moment. So now we've got our plan length of our hip, our rise. So that's going to make that line there the true length of our hip. So that means we can get our level bevel of our hip and our plumb bevel of our hip straight off here. Five and six. So five is the plumb level of the hip. And six. The level bevel. Okay. So now, similar to what we did on this side with the 100 mil, get that out of the road. We're going to do on this side, so we've got here, we've got our 141.4, so we need to take that up at 90 degrees to this line, 141.4, and drop that back down to the apex, and that'll give us here the edge bevel for our hip. Seven. And then number eight, last one we need is the face bevel for our purlin. And that's worked out by taking our rise dimension, which is the one here, 57.7, and transferring that up this line here. So we go up here, 57.7, and we get that point, which is there, and we take it back to our apex. That gives us this bevel in here. And that's number eight. So there we go. There's a very quick and easy way to develop the eight bevels while you're on the site, just using pencil, ruler, and your square. Best thing about this, you could do the board for 30 degrees for one roof and throw it in the truck so you've got it for the next job. If you get another 30-degree roof, or pretty simple to make one up for every common roof pitch that you're going to use. So that's it.